It's January 1st in 1930. Today we'll be looking back at some of the biggest stories of the past decade. I'm your host, Alexandra Gold. So just sit back and relax and enjoy this New Year's Day as we cover the A through Z's of the 1920s. A is for AT&T. January 7th, AT&T established phone lines that can travel across seas to Europe. The transatlantic telephone line transmitted the first phone call to be made across the ocean. B is for Black Tuesday, October 29th, 1929. On this date, share prices on the New York Stock Exchange completely collapsed, becoming a pivotal factor in the emergence of the Great Depression. Yikes! C is for the Charleston. Quick and fun, the Charleston is a widely known dance craze popularized by flapper girls. I guess it was a little too hotsy-totsy since it got banned for being too indecent. Watch out for signs that say, please Charleston quietly. E is for electricity. Industries changed from coal to electricity. Homes also began to be empowered by electricity, allowing them to use some of the new ritzy home appliances like refrigerators. F is for the infamous flappers. The new age brings flappers into the world, redefining womanhood. Cutting their hair into bobs and wearing short dresses with rolled down stockings, these women smoked, drank, and drove like any other man could, and they were just the beginning of the newfound independence of women in this decade. G is for Garvey. Marcus Garvey was a Jamaican-born black nationalist and leader of the Pan-Africanism movement, whose goal was to unify and connect people of African descent worldwide. H is for the Harlem Renaissance, which was the development of the Harlem neighborhood in New York City as a black cultural art and social explosion. I is for inventions. My oh my, these new gizmos sure are the bee's knees. Automobiles, airplanes, washing machines, radios? It's like we're living in the future. J is for jazz. This jazz age is taking America by storm. Big cheeses like Ella Fitzgerald and Duke Ellington sure were swell as they did their part in influencing jazz upon all of us. K is for the KKK. In these past few years, membership soared up to 4 million people nationwide. L is for the League of Nations, formally came into being when the Covenant of the League of Nations took effect. M is for movies, one of the most popular forms of entertainment, bringing out stars like Charlie Chaplin and Mary Pickford. N is for the NAACP. This organization led the black civil rights struggle in fighting social and racial injustices. O is for organized crime, which grew tremendously throughout the Prohibition era. Gangs, burglaries, torpedoes, and lots of crime were common. If I ever got caught up in that, I'd blouse. P is for Prohibition. The infamous ban on alcohol led to lots of speakeasies, giggle water, and whoopee. You know those kiddos love to drink their Jack juice till they upchuck. Q is for quilts. We all know a good quilt can warm you right up. R is for the Red Scare, referring to the fear of communism in the United States, which eventually led to the death of President McKinley. S is for the Scopes Monkey Trial. This was the American legal case between a science teacher teaching evolution and the law. It was illegal to teach modern science in classrooms. T is for transportation. Cars became popular as they got more commonly accessible due to Henry Ford's affordable Model T. Aviator Charles Lindbergh was also the first person to fly solo across the Atlantic Ocean at only 25 years old. U is for upchucking, which happened often after being a little too ossified. V is for votes for women. After suffragettes fought hard for equal gender rights, the 19th Amendment granted women the right to vote. W is for Warren G. Harding, the 29th President of the United States until his assassination in 1923. X is for the many expressions used in the 1920s, like how going on a blind date can give you the heebie-jeebies. Y is for the youth who rebelled against the moral restrictions of past generations. Z is for Zazzled, which many people were in this last decade. That sounds like berries to me. Thanks for tuning in. Talk to you next time.